In this morning's Business Insight, earlier we told you that 1 week from today, the Nancy and David Wolf Holocaust and Humanity Center will open at its new location in Union Terminal. The move from Rockbourne Academy to Union Terminal is significant because it will become the only Holocaust museum in the United States with an authentic connection to its site. Many of the refugees who came to Cincinnati from Europe, including hundreds of survivors of the Holocaust, arrived by train to Union Terminal. In addition, 1 in 5 World War II servicemen and women came through the historic Art Deco train station at some time during the war. Sarah Weiss is the executive director of the Holocaust and Humanity Center. She joins Business Courier producer Kelly Leon in the studio. Sarah and Kelly.
Thanks, Peg. Sarah, thanks so much for being here. We were both just saying we get chills when we hear that. I mean, the thought of the refugees who came through Union Terminal and now we and their ancestors get to go back to that very spot. How did the idea come about to relocate at Union Terminal?
Well, thanks for having me. The idea, the center's been around for the past almost 20 years. Quietly touching many lives, mostly educationally, and we actually wanted to expand our reach. We were embarking on a strategic plan about 4 years ago and began exploring new opportunities in town. We wanted to be in the sort of downtown urban core of the city and really one of the cultural institutions that people would know about. Yeah. And so as we were looking at opportunities, the timing aligned beautifully with the renovation of Union Terminal. So nice. It's really unbelievable that, that our timing aligned. And Union Terminal was looking for one new museum experience to bring into the building as part of the renovation. Mm-hmm. We at the same time were looking to expand our reach and growth, and it aligned because really Elizabeth Pierce and I happened to be at the right place at the right time in the right conversation.
That's fantastic. Yeah. Well, speaking of the experience, talk a little bit about what visitors to the center will see.
Sure. So first, the whole narrative of the museum and the experience connects to the history of the building. Mm-hmm. So when you first walk in and you're walking into the rotunda, into the concourse where people would have taken trains, there are actually sculptures. On one side are documents that people would have needed to arrive, also documents of World War II servicemen, and images of some of the people who would have come through this space. You come down the stairs, the documents continue into our space, which actually overlooks the train tracks, although you might not realize it when you first get in. It starts with a graphic novel style mural done by a local artist named Keith Neltner that was brought to us by our partner at Artworks. And this graphic novel shares the vignettes of about 25 local stories, just snapshots of their stories. And throughout the museum, through media, through testimony, through artifacts, their stories are carried through. The experience starts with an orientation media experience. Woven throughout the galleries is art, media, artifacts, and it ends actually with the Humanity Gallery, which is a challenge to us. So we talk about the Holocaust as one of the darkest chapters of humanity, but what can we learn from this, and what can we do to be better and impact humanity in a positive way from
this? That's fantastic. And in the print story, Janelle Gelfand did the story, and she talks with a woman whose family is connected. Yeah. And that's what I love about this so much, too, is the local connections are just amazing. I mean, I feel like we're so fortunate to have that this place and these local stories.
Yeah, and every day we're learning more and more. You know, as we as people hear about this and know this, they say, "I went through there," or we're finding new documents or stories from archives in the newspapers from 70 years ago. So
yeah, and as you talk, you know, your reach. You're at Rockbourne Academy before, which I'm sure was a fantastic home for many years, but the reach you will have in this location and people coming forward, it's just wonderful. And you have a gala coming up Saturday night to kick it off.
Yes.
It's sold out, so you can't get a ticket, but all the best to you. I really encourage people to go down and take a look. I can't wait to go myself and see it. And thanks for joining us this morning.
Thank you.